This may sound a little strange. I don't have a dream to build a big ministry.
Come on.
I don't. It makes no difference. We raised our kids with an intention that they would shape the course of world history. And we didn't do it in a pressure way, because you can burden them with assignments, you know, that they don't have a grace for. That's not smart. But
I remember growing up, Pastor Bill, watching my own father pastor his church. And sometimes there'll be nobody. And of course, he's Korean. So, you know, he would have the early morning Korean prayers. But he would just be crying out to the Lord in faithfulness. And I'm sure there's so much that your own father and mother have modeled and displayed to you. What would be some of those golden nuggets or keys?
Oh, my dad was, my mom and dad both are such champions of people that are not the most sought after. They would be the one that would champion the person that maybe doesn't qualify to be the missionary, doesn't qualify to be the evangelist or whatever. They're not gifted enough or whatever. He was just a champion of those folks. He'd fight for them. He'd fight for them. He'd give them opportunity, and they became the real heroes of the faith. These people now have been the ones that have impacted the course of history very profoundly, but they were not highly favored when they started. They needed somebody to believe in them. And my dad was just this amazing mercy giver. He could he could visit someone in the hospital, and they would just feel like royalty because of his kindness to them. And and just the value that he had. You know, we went through a time where the church split and because of his approach to the Lord. And yet he kept so kind towards those who left that by the time they came to the end of their life, when one guy, when he was the ringleader of the rebellion, so to speak, he called my dad to please pray for his wife in the hospital.
Wow.
And when she died, he wanted him to do the funeral. And so it's just, you just keep those bridges built. You know, so far as it depends with you, be at peace with all men. That's the scripture.
Yeah.
And that's what he did. He modeled that so powerfully. And I live from the fruit that he fought for.
Wow.
Yeah, it's impacted me tremendously.
Come on.
Yeah.
And I mean, I think really the whole global movement of Bethel, you know, has been surrounded the foundation of family. And, you know, I mean, I love whenever Chris Valentin says, oh, you're a Johnson. And, you know, I mean, it may be very humorous, but there's something just about family.
That's
even
true.
Within your own family with, you know, your children that you serve and you model to the whole world. Tell us about that.
You know, this may sound a little strange. I don't have a dream to build a big ministry.
Come on.
I don't. It makes no difference to me.
Yeah.
But I do have dreams about building big people.
Come on.
I want people to become significant. I want you to stand fully in who God made you to be. So I look at my children. That's what I want for them.
Mm.
I don't care if their title's big. I don't care.
Come on.
But any of those things, as long as they become this passionate lover of Jesus that can illustrate it in who God made them to be. I want them to carry that anointing well, to carry that grace well. And so that's what we've given ourselves to, you know, we raised our kids with an intention that they would shape the course of world history. And we didn't do it in a pressure way, because you can burden them with assignments, you know, that they don't have a grace for. That's not smart. But you can keep promise in front of them. And we would expose them to world need. You know, we'd expose them to pain. We'd expose them to the supernatural, expose them to the promises of God. And it just opened up stuff in them. And so they're running with it. And they're doing really, really beautiful, you know. We have three children, amazing spouses, each of them, and then 10 grandchildren.
Yeah.
And, wow, so much fun.
Wow. You're rich, Pastor Billy.